Good morning, dear students. Let's begin our social science class. Today, I am going to teach you Democratic Politics, Chapter Federalism. What do you mean by federalism? And in which countries federalism is practiced? What are the types of federalism? What is an introduction to federalism? These are all the things we are going to discuss in this chapter. And we'll also see that is the federalism in any country beneficial or not. Overview. In the previous chapter, we noted that vertical division of power among different level of government is one of the major form of power sharing in modern democracies. In this chapter, we focus on this form of power sharing. As I already told in the previous class of democratic politics, we discussed vertical form of power sharing that was among the different level of government. So here we'll be focusing on that. It is commonly referred to as federalism. So here only the definition of federalism comes in our mind. Students, federalism is similar to the word of federation. The federation is act of joining together into a single political entity. When the two governments or the two political bodies join together and divide their powers equally among them, that is a federation. And federalism is that system of the government in which the power is shared. So federation or federalism has two level of government and both of them enjoy power independent of each other. They also do not have any powers on each other. Towards the end of chapter, we turn the local government anew and the third tier of Indian federalism. Now let's have an idea of what is the federalism. Let us get back to contrast between Belgium and Sri Lanka that we saw in the last chapter. You would recall that one of the key changes made in the constitution of Belgium was to reduce the power of central government and give these powers to regional governments. Now whatever power was assembled to the central government and it has rights to, now these were divided equally and were given to the local governments also. Regional government existed in Belgium even earlier. They had their rule and power, but all these powers were given to these government and could be withdrawn by the central government. The change that took place in 1993 was that the regional government were given constitutional powers that were no longer dependent on the central government. Means regional government was now independent of the central government domination. Thus Belgium shifted from a unitary to a federal system. Unitary means a single government system where only one of the government has the rights to everyone, and it only has a right to share its power, and if it does not want to share, it will never share it. Sri Lanka continues to be, for all practice purpose, a unitary system where the national government has all the powers. So in Sri Lanka, we see that the national government has still the powers and it is a form of unitary system. Tamil leaders went to Sri Lanka to become a federal system. So after that, Tamil leaders, they demanded for a federal country where the power was to be divided equally among the central government as well as state government and the regional government of that country. Federalism is a system of government in which the power is divided between a central authority and various constituent units of country. Means it is not assembled in a single hand. Everyone has given an equal share of power, and these all the bodies are independent of each other. Means that there is no system of checks and balances that is to be seen in the federal country. Usually a federation has two levels of government. One is a government for the entire country that is usually responsible for a few subjects of common national interest, and the others are the government at the level of provinces or states that look after much of the day-to-day administrating of their state. Both these levels of government enjoy their power independent of each other. Means no one government body can tell any other government body to share its power or to apply its power, how to apply its power to the public. So that is, they have their powers which are independent of the each other. In this sense, federations are contrasted with unitary governments. Under the unitary system, either there is only one level of government or the subunits are subordinate to the central government, means they are under the power of the central government. The central government can pass on orders to provincial or local government, but in a federal system, the central government cannot order the state government to do something. The state government has its own right to access to its own powers, and no else government body can guide how to access its powers. State government has powers of its own for which it is not answerable to the central government. Both these governments are separately answerable to people. Now let us look some at the key features of federalism. That is an important 5-mark question. So the question starts with, what are the key features of federalism? So there are two or more levels or tiers of government. Different tiers of government. Now here tier refers to the level of the government govern the same citizens, but each tier has its own jurisdiction in specific matters of legislation, taxation and administration. Means it can apply its own laws and can access its own powers in its own way. The jurisdiction of the respective level or tier of government are specified in the constitution, so existence and authority of each tier of government is constitutionally guaranteed. Now we think that these government levels can access their own powers in their own way, so why are they existing? They should not exist in a democratic country, but these jurisdictions are already mentioned in the constitution of how they will access their powers, so these are constitutionally guaranteed, the powers of these governments. The fundamental provision of the constitution cannot be unilaterally changed by one level of government. Such change requires the consent of both the levels of government. Means if any laws changes to be made in the constitution or to be implied to the citizens, then it cannot be decided by only one government. Both the governments should be involved in this process. That is the basic idea of federalism. Courts have the power to interpret the constitution and the powers of different level of government. The highest court acts as an umpire if dispute arises between the different level of government in the exercise of their respective powers. In our country, we see Supreme Court, it acts as an umpire, solve the cases which are between the two different levels of government and if there is any dispute between them. Source of revenue for each level of government are clearly specified to ensure its final financial autonomy. So different government levels takes taxes from the citizens of same citizens of the country. And the seventh one is, the federal system thus has dual objectives. Now this is also important 3-mark question, to safeguard and promote the unity of country. So at one side they need to promote the unity while at the same time accommodate the regional diversity. Regional diversity means some are of different, many people different belong to different religions and they live in a same region. So that is, there is a huge diversity among a single region, that is a regional diversity, and they need to accommodate it or manage it. Therefore, two aspects are crucial for the institution and practice of federalism. Government at different levels should agree to some rules of power sharing. They should also trust that each would abide by its part of agreement. An ideal federal has both the aspects, mutual trust and agreement to live together. So if we think that these federal countries are actually having disputes among them, it is not there because the rules are clearly mentioned in the constitution and these federal countries follow those laws and rules which are mentioned in constitution, and accordingly they imply their laws also. So there is no question of dispute between these levels. So there is has both the aspects, that is mutual trust and agreement to live together. The exact balance of power between the central and the state government vary from one federation to another. This balance depends mainly on historical context in which the federation was formed. There are two kind of routes through which federations have been formed. The state route involves independent states coming together on their own to form a bigger unit. So first is the case when many states come together to form a big unit so that by pooling sovereignty and retaining identity they can increase their security. And this type is called coming together federation. And here the country examples are United States of America, Switzerland, Australia, where it's itself the country was nothing but many states, they came together to form a bigger unit, and this is called as coming together federations. And each state has its own powers and no other state can access the power of other states. In first category of federation, all the constituent states usually have equal power and are strong vice versa the federal government. Now we see the second one, that is the second route is where a large country decides to divide its power between the constituent states and national government. In the we see in Belgium that it was a single state which was having a central government accessing all the powers, but afterwards we see that central government itself decided to divide the powers equally among different levels of government. India, Spain and Belgium are example of this kind of holding together federation. This is known as holding together. Coming together, when the different states come to form a single federation unit, एंड होल्डिंग टुगेदर व्हेन अ सिंगल फेडरेशन यूनिट्स डिवाइड इटसेल्फ इनटू इक्वल डिफरेंट फेडरेशन यूनिट्स स्मॉलर. इन दिस सेकंड कैटेगरी द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट टेंड्स टू बी मोर पावरफुल वाइस वर्सा द स्टेट्स. सो एज वी नो दैट द स्टेट्स व्हेन दे वर कमिंग टुगेदर सो दे वर हैविंग एक्चुअल पावर्स एंड हेंस दे आर मोर पावरफुल देन द गवर्नमेंट द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड हियर द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट डिसाइड्स टू डिवाइड इटसेल्फ इनटू द स्टेट्स एंड दैट्स व्हाई सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एक्सेस मोर पावर्स देन द स्टेट्स. वेरी ऑफन डिफरेंट कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट यूनिट्स ऑफ द फेडरेशन हैव अनइक्वल पावर्स. सम यूनिट्स आर ग्रांटेड स्पेशल पावर्स. वी सॉ योर न्यू वर्ड ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. सो इट इज अ एरिया ओवर विच समवन एज अ legal authority. For example, central government jurisdiction is its own country. The area may be defined in terms of geographical boundary or in terms of certain kind of subjects. Like there are wards divided in between. That is also a type of jurisdiction for the local governments. That's all for today, students. Thank you and have a nice day.